Welcome to our last class. We discussed classification of colloidal solutions in that based on physical state of dispersed phase and dispersion medium we completed, interaction between dispersed phase and dispersion medium completed, charge on dispersed phase particles, charge on colloidal solutions we completed. Now today we are going to discuss fourth classification, that is based on type of DP particles. It is the last classification. Total four type of classifications there. First classification based on physical state of DP and DM, totally eight types that is. Second classification, interaction between DP and DM, means dispersed phase and dispersion medium, lyophilic colloidal solutions, lyophobic colloidal solutions, that is two types. Next one, charge on colloidal solutions based on the two types, positively charged, negatively charged. Oxides, hydroxides are blood, oxides, hydroxides, blood, that is positive colloidal solutions, halides, sulfides, natural colloidal solutions, all are negative colloidal solution. Colloidal solutions contains positive charge, that is positive colloidal solution, negative charge, negative colloidal solution. So it is now the last type is based on type of dispersed phase particles. Here it is based on this, total colloidal solutions are classified into three types. The three types are, here it is, first one, micromolecular colloidal solutions. Micromolecular colloidal solutions, and another one is macromolecular colloidal solutions. Micromolecular colloidal solutions, macromolecular colloidal solutions. Next one here it is associative colloidal solutions. Totally three types present here it is. Micromolecular colloidal solutions, macromolecular colloidal solutions, and associative colloidal solutions. Very simple to understand. First of all here it is micromolecular colloidal solutions. Here colloidal particles size is, size of colloidal, size of dispersed phase particles is 1 millimicron to 1 micron, then only we called that is which solution, colloidal solution. So size of dispersed phase particles is 1 millimicron to 1 micron, then we called that is colloidal solution. Now here it is, listen, we take the solute particles which size is less than 1 millimicron. So means the size less than 1 millimicron we are taking. For suppose here it is, I am forming gold colloidal solution. Here it is, I am just preparing gold colloidal solution. So how I prepare gold colloidal solution? Very simple. This is colloidal particle size, dispersed phase particle size 1 millimicron to 1 micron, then we say colloidal solution. Here micromolecular colloidal solutions means dispersed phase particles or solute particle size we take less than 1 millimicron and we convert them into colloidal solution. Those are micromolecular colloidal solutions. Once again here it is, so colloidal solutions, the dispersed phase particle size compulsory required 1 millimicron to 1 micron. But what are micromolecular colloidal solutions? Means these colloidal solutions are prepared from the solute particles whose size is less than 1 millimicron. So less than 1 millimicron solute particles
we are converting into colloidal solution. That is micro. Macromolecular colloidal solutions means solute particle size is greater than 1 micron. So those, from those we prepare colloidal solutions, those we called macromolecular colloidal solutions. The meaning, solute particle size less than 1 millimicron present, those we call true solutions. So in micromolecular colloidal solutions, we prepare colloidal solutions from true solutions. Macromolecular colloidal solutions, here it is, solute particle size greater than 1 micron means those we call suspensions. Suspensions we convert into colloidal solutions, that is macromolecular colloidal solutions. Very simple to understand. If we prepared any colloidal solution from true solution, that is micromolecular colloidal solution. If we prepare the colloidal solution from suspension, that is macromolecular colloidal solutions. So now here it is, gold colloidal solution I am preparing. Gold colloidal solution, here it is, the RM particle size is, this is very very small present, means that is less than 1 millimicron. And here it is one more, listen carefully. Generally, here it is, this is the, here in this vessel, I am taking water, to this I am adding RM, gold particles I am adding to this. This does not form homogeneous mixture, it forms suspension only. Here RM forming suspension, but RM particle size is not greater than 1 micron. Here RM is forming suspension due to insolubility of this RM in this particular solvent. So means suspensions possible when we dissolve the solute particle size greater than 1 millimicron, and also suspensions possible to create when a particular solute is totally insoluble in a particular solvent. So two chances there, but though that is not in our syllabus. So here it is, you just go through with 1 millimicron to 1 micron present, that is colloidal solution. From this true solution to colloidal solution, that is micromolecular colloidal solution. Suspension particles to colloidal solution, that is macromolecular colloidal solution. Here gold salt I am preparing, this is the RM particle, RM atom. This particle size actually present less than 1 millimicron. Now what I am doing here, it is, this is one more RM atom, here it is one more RM atom, here it is one more RM atom. So this individually, this RM size is less than 1 millimicron, but when these all micro particles associated together, the size lies between 1 millimicron to 1 micron. So now this totally converted to colloidal solution. So this we called micromolecular colloidal solution. Micromolecular colloidal solutions means when the solute particle size is less than 1 millimicron, those many solute particles associated together, the size became in between 1 millimicron to 1 micron. So together these many atoms, the size became in between 1 millimicron to 1 micron means, now this together these all atoms act as colloidal solutions. So this is micromolecular colloidal solutions. We know this is SE8 molecule. Sulfur is octaatomic molecule. O2 diatomic, O3 triatomic, like that. Sulfur is octaatomic. This SE8 molecule size also less than 1 millimicron. But when
many SE8 molecules associated together like this. This particle size, this together these atoms size, sorry, those molecule size lies in between 1 millimicron to 1 micron. Then these all molecules together forms one colloidal solution. So now when micromolecules associated together to give a colloidal solution, that's why this we called micromolecular colloidal solution. Here it is example, they will gold salt, which type of colloidal solution? That is micromolecular colloidal solution. And listen, this is gold salt is lyophobic colloidal solution. So question they frame in NCERT textbook, they given this gold salt example, this gold colloidal solution example in micromolecular colloidal solution, also be they given in lyophobic colloidal solution. So there is a chance to ask the question in the following, which is lyophobic and micromolecular colloidal solution, that is gold salt solution. Gold colloidal solution is example for micromolecular colloidal solution and lyophobic colloidal solution. So NCERT textbook, how to read, this is one of the example. Reading, you read once and then after you just try to get the connections, how they ask the questions. So here it is, simply here it is, gold colloidal solution is example for micromolecular colloidal solution as well as example for lyophobic colloidal solution. So this is micromolecular colloidal solutions. Next, I think you understood what is the macromolecular colloidal solutions. Macromolecular colloidal solutions means the dispersed phase particle size is greater than 1 micron. Means big size solute particles present, those we disintegrate, we divide into small pieces, then the size became in between 1 millimicron to 1 micron. Those we called macromolecular colloidal solutions. Micro means smaller atoms we connect together to create one colloidal solution. Macromolecular colloidal solutions means big size dispersed phase particles or solute particles we divide into small pieces and add to a suitable solvent. Then colloidal solution will come, that is macromolecular colloidal solution. Here it is, examples for this macromolecular colloidal solution, starch solution. Take starch and add to water, one colloidal solution will come, that is example for macromolecular colloidal solution. Gum colloidal solution, macromolecular colloidal solution. Cellulose dissolves in water, macromolecular colloidal solution. Why? Because starch size, cellulose size, it is greater than 1 micron present. So those all will give which type of colloidal solution? Macromolecular colloidal solutions. Now I am going for associative colloidal solutions. Before going to this associative colloidal solutions, once again regarding this micromolecular colloidal solution and macro. Smaller atoms connected together to increase size between 1 millimicron to 1 micron. Those are micromolecular, gold salt and SE8 molecules. Macromolecular, big size atoms are divided into small pieces to get size between 1 millimicron to 1 micron. Examples are starch solution, cellulose solution, gum solution. So all these are examples for macromolecular colloidal solutions. Then what are associative colloidal solutions? Associative colloidal solutions means associative colloidal solutions. associative collider solutions means collide here it is some solution you are taking a particular solution any solution you take this solution I am taking at two different concentrations one is at low concentration another one is I am taking at high concentration one is at low concentration another one is at high concentration same solution a particular solution I am taking at low concentration and high concentration at low concentration it forms true solution at high concentration it forms collider solution now this solution we called associative collider solution so means a particular solution is giving true solution at low concentration but collider solution at high concentration combination is same only but concentration changing by changing the concentration true solution it became collider solution those we called associative collider solution but listen carefully all does not form associative collider solutions for suppose I am taking water in a vessel for that I am adding sodium chloride you take low concentration or high concentration that forms true solution only so that's why reason all does not form associative collider solutions very few combinations will give this associative collider solutions and if any compound forming associative collider solution to form that associative collider solution compulsory at low concentration that is forming true solution at high concentration the same solution is converting true solution to collider solution what is the concentration required to convert this true solution to this collider solution that concentration we called as critical Mitchell concentration critical Mitchell concentration simply this we called as CMC critical Mitchell concentration what is critical Mitchell concentration here it is associative collider solution here why we are calling critical Mitchell concentration means for this associative collider solutions the other name is Mitchell's so that's why to form Mitchell what is the concentration required that we called critical Mitchell concentration here one more thing is the temperature required we called Kraft temperature we denote with Kf it is not forward reaction constant Kraft temperature Kf what is Kraft temperature means to form associative collider solution what temperature required the temperature we called Kraft temperature the concentration required is critical Mitchell concentration so now here in this critical Mitchell concentration regarding they will ask the questions listen this critical Mitchell concentration is always inversely proportional to alkyl group length of alkyl group length of alkyl group that meaning length of alkyl group increases critical Mitchell concentration means required concentration to convert this true solution to collider solution decreases means formation of Mitchell become easy once again I am repeating here length of alkyl group increases critical missile concentration decreases. Meaning, what is critical missile concentration? Required concentration to make true solution to collider solution. So that required concentration decreasing means at low concentration only we can convert this true solution to collider solution. So we can make this true solution to collider solution very easily. We can convert this true solution to collider solution very easy. So means they will give in the following which contains lesser critical missile concentration, which is more critical missile concentration. So like that the questions they will ask. For suppose reason here only, which forms collider solution, which forms missile easily, which forms associative collider solution easily. Here question. Which forms missile easily? Which forms missile easily? Option 1, here it is. Like this I am taking. So this is alkyl part. 2 carbons, 1, 2, 3 carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 carbons. Here it is 2 carbons. Here it is 3 carbons, 1, 2, 3. Here it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons. Means alkyl chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 carbons in the alkyl chain. So here it is, this chain is bigger chain. So length of alkyl group here more, fourth one. So required concentration is less. So means it forms very easily missile. So like this we can give answers there. So this is associative collider solution. But listen, under this associative collider solution, one important topic in our syllabus, that is cleaning action of soap. What is this cleaning action of soap? Here it is. Cleaning action of soap. Cleaning action of soap. Why they given this cleaning action of soap under missile concept means it is related to missile. Soap, when cleaning the clothes, when removing dirt from the clothes or dust from the clothes, it forms missile. So that's why they given here cleaning action of soap. Here it is, soaps totally two types. One is normal soaps, another one is detergent soaps. So here it is, C17H35COONA. This we called sodium stearate. Sodium stearate. Listen here, it is, this is normal soap. Listen, normal soap means here it is RCOO minus, like this present normal soap. Detergent soap means R bond SO3 minus. Alkyl group present with SO3 minus, that is detergent soap. Alkyl group present with COO minus, that is normal soap. So detergent soap to normal soap is the difference in the this functional group only. COO minus present, that is normal group. Here it is, sodium stearate is normal soap or detergent soap means it is normal soap. C17H35COO minus and Na plus RCOO minus, that's why this is normal soap. RSO3 minus present, that we called detergent soap. So this is This is detergent soap. This is the normal soap. This is normal soap. So now here in this C17H35COONA, just here it is, I'm writing this first carbon, second carbon, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 and 17. So C17 over. So now this is double bond O, bond O minus, and here it is Na plus. Total 18 carbon, 17 in alkyl group, 1 is in functional group. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 and O minus Na plus. So now in this we have to understand, this is carbon-carbon bonds, these are. Any polarity will come here, it is C bond. C means both sides same present, means electronegativity same, means it is poles no chance to develop. That's why this is totally, this alkyl group is there now, that we called non-polar part. Here to this total alkyl group up to here, this we called non-polar part. Non-polar part, in textbooks they will give this is tail part. Look like tail, that's why this we called tail part. And this is soap. When we add to water, soap is a polar solvent, it is a non-polar salt, non-polar part. Water, sorry, when we dissolve this soap in water, this is totally non-polar part, but water is a polar solvent. Here solubility, like dissolve like means polar compounds soluble in polar solvents, non-polar compounds soluble in non-polar compounds. Sodium chloride, Na plus Cl minus, poles there. Poles means here plus minus poles. So sodium chloride is a polar solvent. Sodium chloride is a polar compound. Water is a polar solvent. That's why polar, that's why solubility possible. Here in this, sir, ammonia also dissolve in water. Ammonia also there polar solvent. How polar solvent means, I will explain later. That is, here it is simple, listen carefully, you remember to understand this part. This is non-polar part, this is totally. Water is a polar solvent. So we are understanding here it is, this part is not dissolved in water. But listen carefully, here it is, here pole is present. When we dissolve in water, this sodium stearate will dissociate into C17H35COO- and Na+. So here pores present. Pores present means this Na+, no need to write down, this no participation in the cleaning. So here it is C double bond O minus, this is there now. This part is, this is non-polar part, but this is polar part. How I say polar means pole is there here, minus pole is there. That's why that is polar part. So polar part, this we called head part. And here it is, this is tail part. It is not attracted by water. It not dissolves in water, not attracted by water. So water repellent, this part is. Water repellent, that's we call as hydrophobic part. This is hydrophobic part. Why? Because it is repelled by the water. And this is the polar part, it is head part. It is attracted by water. That's why this we called hydrophilic part. Philic means attraction, phobic means repulsion. Not repulsion, no attraction. So here no attraction present, that's why we called hydrophobic part. Here attraction is there, that's why we called hydrophilic part. It is, one is philic. Hydrophilic part, hydrophobic part. So now here it is, I'm taking water in a bucket. So this is in this vessel, in this bucket, I'm taking water. What are micelles means? At low concentration they form true solution. While increasing the concentration, the same true solution became colloidal solution. So now in this first, I am adding very small quantity of soap to this. When I add very small quantity of soap to that water, excess amount of water, this part already we know that is water repellent part, hydrophobic part, tail part, because that is a non-polar nature. So this moves away from the water, and this is hydrophilic part, head part. Why it is hydrophilic part means it is polar nature. So this part is attracted by water, this part is repelled by the water. So that's why in this water, this C17H35COO-, this part is water repellent part, this part is water attracting part. So here it is, tail part is move away from the surface and head part is inside the water. So like this, these particles, this tail part is hydrophobic part, that's why that is water repellent, it is moving away from the water surface, and these are water attracting parts, that's why those present inside the water. So now here in this, much quantity of water present, very less quantity of soap present. That's why what happened, it forms a true solution. True solution at which concentration? Low concentration. That's why at low concentration soap, you see this is very clear and transparent present. Now in this same water, I'm increasing the soap quantity. When I increase soap quantity, what happened here it is, the surface is constant. That surface is constant, but we are increasing soap particles in that. So here it is, what happened, how much possible that many soap particles they accumulate like this. But due to very limited surface area, the newly coming soap particles, those are not get like this surface. But the condition you don't forget, this tail part is hydrophobic part, this head part is hydrophilic part, but the surface area is limit. So like this arrangement is not possible furtherly when we are adding excess amount of soap into this. At that time what happened here it is, this all tail parts are, if you are taken one circle here it is, all tail parts are moved center to this circle, and all head parts they frame one film on this. So now this is head part, tail part, head part, tail part, head part, tail part. So like this, like this present. Here I am showing gaps. This gaps not present when we are doing experiment. Actually in that experiment there was no gaps. Here it is, all are, we are adding much quantity of soap. So like this we are adding. So now this all head parts are acting as a film, and this tail parts are associated towards the center. So like that throughout the cloth, like this what happened, many soap particles are arranged like this. The tail parts are towards the center of the circle, and head parts are present on the surface of the circle. So like this, what happened here it is, these soap particles individually present, their size is less than 1 millimicron. But now this size is lies in between 1 millimicron and micron. So now here it is, true solution, when associated like this, it become
collider solution. So means when we are added very low concentration, it is true solution. When we increase soap quantity, means when we increase the concentration, the same soap solution became colloidal solution. Same true solution became colloidal solution. That's why this we called micelle. Now throughout the cloth, like this micelles are forming means where dirt or dust or grease present, there also like this micelle formation present. Meaning the dust, for suppose if you are taken, this is dust or grease or whatever it may be, if you are taken, the tail parts are immersed into dust or grease. And here it is. Why? Because dust and grease, those are not water. So means what happened here it is, this tail part is water repellent part. So means it is always searching for a source where water not present. That's why where dust or grease present, that is not a water particles. That's why what happened, these tail parts are very interested to immerse into that dust or grease particles. Why? Because this tail part is very much interested to enter into other than water area. Why? Because it is hydrophobic part. So normal area, this micelle formation where dirt or dust or grease present, in that area this micelle formation, if we compare in grease area or dust area or dirt area, this micelle formation became very effective. So here it is, once like this micelle formed over, when we are using washing machine or mechanical disturbance with hands, by using machine when we are disturbing the cloth or by using hands we are disturbing the cloth, what happened, by rubbing like this, what happened, these tail parts are moves inside the dust or grease. When we are moving like this fastly, what happened, these tail parts which are present inside the grease also will move. That's why this grease will divide into small pieces. Then after, when we dipped the cloth in excess amount of water, this small pieces with that excess amount of water forms again true solution, and this will leave the cloth. So like this, this is the cleaning action of soap. Once again listen carefully, here it is. At low concentration, this is the true solution. In the same quantity of solvent, we are increasing soap amount. When we are increasing soap concentration, what happened? The surface area is limited. That's why like this arrangement is not possible. But these tail parts are compulsory need to avoid the water. At that moment, what happened? These head parts all are forms one circle. The tail parts are forced towards the center. Like that, themselves they avoid the water connectivity. And next, what happened? Like this, throughout the cloth will go. So now at this moment, what happened here? It is the size of dispersed phase particles became one less than 1 millimicron to in between 1 millimicron and micron. So now that converted to colloidal solution that we called micelle. Now throughout the cloth like this micelles will form, but where grease or dust present, at that area again these tail parts are getting their suitable medium. Why? Because they didn't want any water. Why? Because those are water repellent. That's why those easily immersed into dust or grease. After that, when we are agitating clothes or when we are rubbing the clothes, what happened? Along with this tail part, where the tail parts present inside this dust, by moving this all tail parts, this total dust also will break into small pieces. Means again size is decreasing. So when we finally dipped in X amount of water, these small pieces will dissolve in water and they washed out along with the water, the cloth become very clean. So this is totally cleaning action of soap. Okay, that's all. Next class we will discuss preparation of colloidal solutions. But next video I am not uploading the surface chemistry. Next video I am uploading some questions regarding Sunday exam. So again regarding this surface chemistry, I will upload the video on Monday. Right. Thank you, beta. Thank you very much.